Could Smilodon survive nowadays? A smile from this mouth sent shivers down anyone's spine. Smilodon. They didn't name him that because he had a friendly smile. No, far from it. If you take a look at the full name, Smilodon Fatalis, that means fate scalpel tool or two-edged knife. Yeah, not the name of an animal that you want to be associating with. Those gigantic teeth also earned Smilodon the name saber-toothed tiger, though it's not related to today's tiger. But what if Smilodon did live today, whether alongside the tiger or alongside other modern animals? How would that work? Could Smilodon survive? They went extinct once. What would happen if they got a second chance? When and where? The first thing we need to do is figure out just when and where the Smilodon lived. Since Smilodon has been extinct for around 10,000 years, let's start with the when. Smilodon lived in the time frame of about 2.5 million years ago to about 10,000 years ago. So Smilodons roamed the Earth just short of 2.5 million years. Now that time frame spanned across two different epochs. The Pleistocene epoch was from 2.6 million years ago to 11,700 years ago. And then picking up where the Pleistocene epoch left off was the Holocene epoch, which spanned from 11,700 years ago to present day. Although it sounds like it was so long ago to say Smilodon went extinct 10,000 years ago, it doesn't sound so long when you realize they actually lived in the same epoch that we live in. In fact, humans and Smilodons coexisted much of that time during the Ice Age. And when you look at the grand scheme of things, our planet, which is 4.54 billion years old, our current era and the Smilodon era are quite close to one another. That's the when. How about the where? Well, Smilodon fossils have been found all over the Americas. They've been in South America, Central America, and even North America. In fact, one of the spots they are quite famously found in, of all places, is Los Angeles. It was quite different back then, though. But a famous attraction of Los Angeles is the La Brea Tar Pits, where many Smilodon fossils have been found. In fact, that is the second most common fossil that has been found in the La Brea Tar Pits after the dire wolves. But they didn't stop at Los Angeles. Smilodons were known to have lived as far north as Alberta, Canada. Also, they lived as far south as the Patagonia region of South America, Chile, and Argentina. In addition to being all up and down the Americas, the Smilodon also lived in Europe. Fossils of the Smilodon have washed up on UK shores from the North Sea. It's believed that Smilodons preferred to live in closed habitats like forests and bush. So anywhere that they could find forests or anything similar throughout Europe and the Americas, those would be ideal habitats. And that is something that Europe and the Americas has a lot of now. And when you look back to the times before human civilization really kicked off, there was an even larger supply of trees and forests. Smilodons would have littered these continents. It would have been hard not to run into one. These big cats lived from LA to London, and plenty of other places. But how would they fare in LA or London today? They might not appreciate the lack of forests and the surplus of buildings. Or what about in other places that they used to inhabit? The places they called home are vastly different today. How much would things change if Smilodon came right back in the same numbers that they used to exist in? Smilodon Details. Hold on, we still haven't spent enough time analyzing the Smilodon. Yeah, we know when and where they lived, but we also need to know the what. As in, what exactly was Smilodon? What was Smilodon's size? What did Smilodon eat? All important things to know. Now, first, Felidae is the family of mammals in the order of Carnivora. You might call a member of this family a felid, or a cat. Now, this family breaks off into subfamilies. One is Pantherinae, which includes tigers, lions, jaguars, and leopards. There is also Felinae. This includes cougars, ocelots, and domestic cats. Then there is the subfamily of Macerodontinae. This subfamily is completely extinct and includes Dinofelis, Homotherium, and of course our friend Smilodon. So that's an important distinction to make. Though all of those animals are in the same family, Smilodon or the saber-toothed tiger is not in the same subfamily as cougars or lions or jaguars or even tigers. Smilodons were around the same size as some of our modern big cats, but the big difference was that they were more robustly built. They had broad limbs and comparatively short feet. They also had much shorter tails. But then again, they made up for it with much bigger teeth. Now, technically, there were three different Smilodons. We had Smilodon gracilis, the smallest of the three. He was about 120 to 220 pounds in weight, about the size of a jaguar. However, more stout and less agile. There was Smilodon fatalis, the one we mentioned previously, with the name meaning two-edged knife. Well, he was bigger. He would be between 350 and 620 pounds. You're looking at a Smilodon more similar to a lion in dimensions. A shoulder height of 39 inches and a total body length of about 69 inches, just below 6 feet long. So picture a lion with huge teeth. Oh, and it's more muscular. Scary thought, right? But we haven't reached the biggest Smilodon yet, the Smilodon populator. This guy is most comparable to a tiger, the biggest of all the living big cats on Earth. This one could range from 500 pounds to 900 pounds. He stood 47 inches at the shoulder. Many estimates say that Smilodon populator was 7.5 to 8 feet long, which is a bit smaller than the biggest tigers. However, a Smilodon populator skull was found in Uruguay, which measured 15.4 inches in length, and scientists determined that would mean this particular animal would have weighed over 1,000 pounds. Additionally, in Argentina, fossil tracks were found of a Smilodon populator, which was 6.9 inches by 7.6 inches, which is larger than the tracks of a Bengal tiger. For the meantime, let's just use the comparisons we have, because they're pretty close. Smilodon gracilis is about the size of a jaguar. Smilodon fatalis is about the size of a lion. Smilodon populator is about the size of a tiger. But in all three cases, more stout, more muscular, however, a touch less agile. And with those front saber teeth measuring at about 7 to 8 inches long. And using those gigantic teeth, the Smilodon hunted primarily large mammals. It was determined based on preserved isotopes in the bones, specifically from the fossils found in the La Brea tar pits, that Smilodons ate many ruminants like bison and camels. And the bison back then were even bigger than the bison today. They also were found to eat llama-like animals that existed back then, tapirs and deer. Smilodon was a predator, but in terms of him being an apex predator, it did depend on which Smilodon we are talking about and where exactly he was. Smilodon populator was most likely always an apex predator, but the other two smaller Smilodons may have been in contention with dire wolves and the American lion due to their smaller sizes. It's an interesting fact that they can thrive as both an apex predator and also just another predator. Due to Smilodon's large and muscular size and its shorter tail, it likely hunted much differently than many of today's big cats. Scientists believe it would have been completely terrestrial, not climbing in trees like leopards and many big cats do. It had smaller, weaker eyes, and the short tail would not have helped with its balance when running. Big cats are ambush predators, but the Smilodon would have had to have been even more heavily reliant on the ambush aspect. But clearly his methods got the job done. But will they get the job done in modern times? The modern Smilodon. To be fair, we'll have to drop these Smilodons off in the same places they used to inhabit. So we're dropping Smilodons off all over the Americas and in Europe as well. The first two big shocks that they'll experience will be the explosion of human civilization and the much warmer climate. Because Smilodons spanned so much area in the Americas, though, they proved they were adaptable. They lived in frigid temperatures in Canada, but they also lived near the equator, though the temperatures at the equator would have been cooler then. Smilodon, with his huge size, is much better suited for cold temperatures, but he could adapt to the warmth. But in this warmer era, they may migrate far north and south in order to embrace the cold. That would also be a wise decision, so that they could avoid areas that are heavily populated with people in cities and towns. Not to say a Smilodon would be scared of one human, or even 10 humans, but any group of humans with guns would be a problem. Now we have Smilodons the size of tigers, lions, and jaguars, but the areas in which Smilodons would be inhabiting, there would be no tigers or lions. If we are talking about Central and South America, there would be jaguars. And in North America, there would be the comparable and slightly smaller cougar. If we're going as far north as Canada or looking at Europe, the biggest cats there would be hyenas. And if we go as far south as Patagonia, jaguars don't live down there. So in terms of other big cats, Smilodons won't have to worry about being smaller anywhere they go. They'd have to watch out for bears, crocodiles, alligators, and other predators, but they've already proven that they can coexist with other predators. They don't always have to be the apex predator, but they would thrive throughout much of the Americas. Even if the smaller Smilodons were in contention with the similar-sized jaguars and cougars, they'd still be able to coexist. They'd find their forests, and they'd return to their predatory habits. There are plenty of the same types of large mammals that they'd want to eat. And in all honesty, they'd likely prefer to go to the coldest regions to remind themselves of their home era. And if they did so, they'd have less competition when it came to predators. In Canada, if they avoided the bears, they'd be top dogs. And even the larger Smilodons may be top dog anyway. In Patagonia, as we mentioned, they'd thrive. Plenty of llamas for the picking, and not too many competitors. They'd love the cold temperatures. If they returned to their stomping grounds in Europe, heading into the forests, they'd only see the Eurasian lynx, which is 66 pounds, tiny compared to them. They'd see brown bears weighing 700 pounds, which would be comparable in size to Smilodon fatalis, but smaller than Smilodon populator. And then there would also be wolves, but no wolf comes close to their size. Europe would offer much of the same prey they used to enjoy. If they went to Northern Europe, there would be many deer and moose and even reindeer. The Smilodon's hunting tactics would still work in this day and age. Smilodon's cousins, the modern big cats, prove this to be true. Modern big cats may be quicker and more agile, but Smilodon is more powerful. And it's not as if he doesn't have any speed. As soon as he got his claws and those 8-inch teeth on the hide of his chosen prey, no one would be getting away. The biggest thing they'd have to adapt to would be the people and the temperatures. But in terms of competition, they'd have no worries. They'd continue to be successful predators, and in many cases, still apex predators.